And we are back. We are back, everybody, with Comatose Wrestling here today. We are going to have a good time. But first of all, let's go ahead and get into some news. Well, actually, hold up. Before we go on, my name is Knight. I am one of the commentators during these matches. I'm also one of the participants. I'm one of the wrestlers here. All right? Now, if I could have my co-host with me, Astral Projections. Are you here? Are you here, Astral?
You heard my name.
Yes, yes. Hello. Welcome in, Astral. Want to introduce yourself?
Yeah, so I am Astral. I am also a commentator, also one of the wrestlers. And I am actually a huge wrestling fan, so I have a little bit of knowledge in my brain.
Yes, so when it came to
I'm going to kind of help out.
Absolutely. Whenever it came to finding a co-host to this show, the first person I thought of was Astral, of course, because she is also a huge wrestling fan. So we are now here. We are ready to start Comatose Wrestling. Now, Astral, as you can see here, we got Donkey Kong versus Harambe. Do you think that we'll see most of this kind of wacky stuff throughout the night?
I'm hoping so. I think this first match is going to start off really well. I don't know which side to go for yet, but I think these wacky matches put a good part in the match.
Awesome, awesome.
So who are you going for in this first match?
In this one, see, now I have always been a Mario player. So I'm going to have to go with Donkey Kong for this one. Donkey Kong, you know, he has that strength. He's been throwing barrels over at Mario for a long time, for years. And he became a wrestler. He became a fighter. He became a race car driver. You know, Donkey Kong is a man of many talents.
Yeah, I guess Donkey Kong does have a lot on his belt. But, yeah. I mean, look at Harambe with that kid. Harambe is obviously a crowd's favorite too, so.
That is true. Plus, not to mention, ever since Harambe's death, the years haven't been too kind to us, has it?
No, it hasn't really.
First coming in to the ring, the almighty Donkey Kong. Look at him, the crowd loves him, pointing at all his fans. Made by the game underscore, I didn't even read that. Oh!
Ooh.
See, now he has that. He has those hops on him.
Okay. Let's see how this is gonna go.
Let's see. Okay. The crowd is loving him so far. Oh, snap. Kong ready to wreck.
Ooh, and I hear that Undertaker entrance. They gave Harambe the Undertaker entrance? Nah.
Yeah. Oh.
Harambe's about to dominate this.
Can't do it. And he's coming in on a motorcycle?
Oh no, he's ready.
Gorilla! Dead man equals Harambe dead. That's true. Harambe is dead. Rest in peace, Harambe.
That is, good entrance then. It really fits.
He just draws attention because of the music.
Yeah.
Like, you can't help but to sit and stare. Maybe even stand and stare.
You know, I heard some rumors in the back that that kid is actually in the crowd tonight, and Harambe said if he wins, he wants him in the ring next.
Oof. Stadium being... Somebody Mochi clipped that.
Thank you.
Okay, I mean, that wasn't what I was trying to go for, but sure, I guess. Y'all can take that.
Well, you said it.
I mean, okay.
Comatose Wrestling is just about to be night with, like, a bunch of pocket clips
out of context. Oh, here we go. Okay, they're already going after. Oh, Harambe, kick.
Ooh, Harambe is already taking the lead
right here. Meanwhile, Donkey Kong is still laying on the ground. Donkey Kong needs to come back some way, somehow, in order to win this. But so far, Harambe seems to have the power.
Yeah, he's got the upper hand.
Stamina,
sure.
And the hops. Oh! A punch on Harambe. There we go.
Ooh, he goes off of the ropes. Harambe's coming back, though.
Not surprising that they have immense strength, them both being gorillas. A couple hip thrusts. Anywho,
Harambe's definitely taunting him.
Definitely. Mochi, thank you so much for staying as long as you could. It's been great. You have a good night.
Yes. Bye, Mochi.
Meanwhile, Dami is saying, grab his dick and twist it. They're at the 5 count right now. They need to get back inside the ring in order to stay in. Harambe outside. 7 count and is back in. Oh, what that flip.
He completely missed that.
Nice, so it was a hit, but it's a little shaky at the back end of it. Give him the good old dick twist. Was that a spin-a-rooney?
That's what it looks like.
1, 2. It wasn't enough.
This could have been an early match.
Kicked out on the 2 count. Now, it's another spin-a-rooney. Donkey Kong is stunned.
Really just...
1, 2, 3. Harambe is the winner.
That was a good match, but Harambe definitely just, you know.
Harambe came.
Really kicked it in.
Conquered. And that is it. That's all she wrote, everybody.
Yep.
Harambe is the winner. Should have seen that coming.
Harambe's got that built-up anger, you know. He was ready.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, we would ask him to come back to Sage to do a post-match interview. Unfortunately, we do not speak gorilla. Next one up, we have the DC girls themselves, 2 members of the Birds of Prey, and lovers / fighters themselves. Poison Ivy versus Harley Quinn. Here we go, people. This has been a fight that was supposed to happen. Yes, Poison Ivy versus Harley Quinn.
Say, Poison Ivy's great. I'm sure she's got the move. When you just put it against Harley Quinn, there's no contest. Harley Quinn's gonna whip her ass.
Yeah, I mean, you gotta remember that Poison Ivy.
I'm putting down my pick.
Poison Ivy's main attacks are her plants. She does know a little bit of hand-to-hand combat, but when it comes to actual combat, like mano a mano, Harley Quinn has it all. She has the strength.
Look at Harley Quinn, Mortal Kombat.
She has the agility. I'm going to have to give this one to Harley.
Yeah.
So let's go see what Margot Robbie can do.
Jesus, holy bazonkas.
Yeah, holy bazonkas.
They're definitely there.
They are there. She proprio saying that Harley or Ivy has his money. First one out, we have Poison Ivy.
Yeah.
The crowd is booing.
They're not too far with Poison Ivy in this one. Okay.
Jesus and woo! Woo! Poison Ivy blowing a kiss to the crowd.
Okay.
Crowd is cheering.
But
I also hear some boos.
Yeah, it's a mixed reaction. I always feel like that if you have a mixed reaction of cheers and boos, that means you're a good wrestler.
Yeah, absolutely.
We love to see it, you know.
Proper is saying that if she loses, it's because of her breasts are too massive. I think they're just right. But hey, you know what?
I wish Mochi didn't leave, because that would have been a great clip, too.
From
She's a winner no matter what. That's what G says. Quinn. Harley Quinn.
Ooh, with her hair kind of stuck in the jacket. It's all right, though.
Now, I heard that the Joker is actually in the crowd tonight.
Ooh. I mean, hey, to watch this girl, I get it.
I mean, it's good to be Poison Ivy trying to knock some sense to Harley Quinn once again. Because let's be honest, like, Harley Quinn has not had the best track record when it comes to picking men.
No. Meow. Tyler.
Lyrics with the meow.
Are we gonna get a lyrics pop up on commentary?
She says
I can pick her.
But which one? Which one? Poison Ivy or Harley?
Jokes on you. He meant both of them.
Ivy wouldn't hurt Harley like that. I will not lie.
Oh, gee. Maybe I spoke too soon.
Maybe.
Harley Quinn is definitely getting it handed to her. It's not a good look right now.
Ooh. See, you expected like a better performance out of Harley Quinn.
Yeah. But hey, the match just started. Don't trash on her too much yet. She could have a good comeback.
She needs to do something soon.
Yeah. Have a little faith in her.
Oh, there we go.
Okay. I just got word from Lyrics. Punch. He is getting changed in the changing rooms and he'll be at the booth soon. So we do get a legendary Lyrics from commentary.
Nice. Bruno says, I got to get a closer look.
Oh my gosh. Bruno's sneaking up to the front row.
Ooh.
See, I told you.
Okay, maybe this could be Harley making a comeback here, because Poison Ivy is stunned a little bit.
Ooh.
Right. We're already going for the pin. One, two, just one. Harley Quinn just put on a huge performance. Oh, backflip, knee dive
into the stomach.
Once again, a couple stomps, picking up Poison Ivy. Dami saying Ivy beating the shit out of Harley for going back to Joker once more. Probably that's what's happening. Oh, and over the top rope, Harley Quinn throws Poison Ivy. One.
Harley is not playing around. Looks like Ivy is bringing her back up.
They're trying to go at each other. It looks like it's kind of even. Poison Ivy is a little bit more injured than Harley.
Yep. Lay it to the neck, not always fun.
Oh, but it looks like Harley has a little buff. Now it's gone. Never mind.
Yeah, it does look like Poison has some slight just chest tension, so we'll hope it's not too bad.
Harley Quinn is getting a little bit of head damage right there. And kicking out a two count. Oh, Poison Ivy's going up top. Flying through the air. Oh! She elbow into Harley Quinn.
Yeah. Ooh, she did miss that one, it looks like. Harley rolled out of it just in time. Alright, take the punches to the gut.
Harley Quinn's a little bit dazed here, and now totally stunned. Yep. Trying to protect
and
herself.
Still throwing punches.
A flurry of blows to the head. Harley Quinn is trying to get up. Poison Ivy says, no! Get back down!
Ooh. Yeah, she's not done with her yet.
One. Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Now.
Poison Ivy is our winner for this match.
Harley, leave the Joker, please.
If that was her message, I feel like it definitely got across.
Oh, yeah. No, it definitely has. Wow. Quick match. It was a quick match. Oh, but... Oh, what do we have here? Oh,
are they going to handshake on it? Are they? They're back on good terms.
They're back on good terms.
Code of honor.
They're still, you know, besties at the end of the day. Oh, you know what? That might be something to see.
Yeah.
The DC besties. versus our besties. What do you think?
I could be down for that.
You and Cheryl going up against Poison Ivy and Harley?
I'm down to fight them. I feel like it'd be, not gonna lie, with me and Cheryl, I feel like it'd be an easy match.
Alright, now for the next match.
Alright, who we got?
We have Who versus Bruno. I told Bruno that he was going against somebody else. Bruno, I'm sorry for the lie. My bad. I forget. But here we are, Who versus Bruno. Now, see, if Bruno wins here, then he becomes the 24/7 champion.
Ooh. Now, as good as a wrestler as Who is, I'm hoping Bruno gets that title. I think he deserves it. He's been working hard.
Who has held the title for a while now? I'm surprised nobody else has taken it. We had like a couple matches to where, he did. He did win up against so many different odds, but, you know, he came out on top. So we're going to have to see who wins here, because Bruno is still a force to be reckoned with. He injured Minecraft Steve.
Oh, yeah, he put him out. So that puts in my head, there's no doubt that I think Bruno could beat him for the title.
Absolutely. So let's go ahead and check this out. Accept. Proprio saying Bruno is hungry. Oh, yeah, he is. There goes our 24/7 champion. Who?
Yeah.
Who is our 24/7 champion?
Yep, he's in his iconic white baseball outfit. He's ready.
From New York, weighing in at 163 pounds, the 24/7
champion. Who's that? It's Who that? There we go. Who is here indeed? You know, he's ready. He's a champ right now. Who is saying who is gonna win?
Yeah. I don't know.
Who is cheering up the crowd right now?
Yep. Definitely trying to get the people on his side.
Definitely. I mean, you kind of have to. You are the 24/7 champ. You have to defend your title. And here comes Bruno.
Oh, yeah. Look at him. He's ready.
Look at him. He's pumping himself up. Going in for a light jog. Bruno!
Is ready.
Shout out to all the names I was actually able to get in here that I was actually able to find for the announcer to actually say. Because that was hard.
Alright, he's warming himself up.
You know, he's getting himself prepared because this could be his first belt.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you always gotta start somewhere.
Yeah, he needs to get his head in the game. He's got to focus. It's the only way to beat Who. Alright.
Already with the grab, but with the push away. No, once again.
Yep. Looks like he's reversing it.
And, oh! And Bruno's picking up Who.
Hit.
Oh, but it was reversed by Who. Driving Bruno's head into the ground. And already with the kicks.
Ooh.
Who is out here just showing everybody why he is still a 24/7 champion. Right off the bat.
Those baseball cleats.
Already going for
nice.
One. Two.
Two.
Kicked out at two.
That
could have been it.
I was a little worried, I'm not gonna lie.
So was I. Like that there's no way that could have been that fast.
Right, he's could be back for a hit.
Oh. Bruno, man, come on, you gotta get up, you gotta actually do something here.
Yeah.
Oh, already kicked to the head.
Oh, is Who going for a submission move this early?
Oh. With the stomp on the leg.
Yeah.
Oh, here comes Bruno. It's been reversed by Who?
Who's not letting him have a chance?
Who is out here? just dominating everybody who comes up to him. Bruno's still trying to like do something here, but who is barely letting him have a chance? Face to the apron.
Yeah.
Cheering up the crowd.
Bruno's got to lock it in. He's got to get the upper hand. Even if he can get a punch in, that could definitely set him up.
Now, this is a false count anywhere match, so anything could happen. Oh, on top.
Ooh, slammed to the ground. I know that hurt. There we go. See?
A few blows.
So I told you just got to get one punch in and you can get the upper hand. That's exactly what Bruno's doing right now.
Oh, dropped on the apron. Bruno really loves like damaging people using that apron, doesn't he? And revenge to the steel staircase.
Ooh.
Bruno
stopped the arm and he's picking him up. Look at that strength of Bruno, man.
Yo, y'all ever seen Dirty Dancing? Oh, just dropping Bruno on the floor.
Oh, we got to kick in.
And just
toss Bruno. Bruno's got to get his head back in the game. He's got to get that advantage.
Oh, clothesline. Ooh. Bruno's taking on some head damage. Oh, reversal. Slammed onto the ground. Here we go. Oh.
We're going for a pin.
One. That ref really needs to choose a spot that is more convenient because that was no way. That was just one.
Ref is like right up on Bruno. All up in his personal space.
And leg sweep. Picking Bruno back up. A couple more blows.
Alright. Ooh.
Head dive right into the floor.
Yes, man. Sir.
Oh wait, was Bruno here?
Bruno
right into that.
Though.
I wonder how.
Onto the ground.
How did that not help hurt him? Who's wearing a helmet?
I don't know. Sometimes you just don't question what happens in wrestling.
Yeah, I guess so.
Bruno can reverse.
Bruno is bleeding currently.
Ooh.
They're just going back and forth with the blows. Bruno is currently stunned.
Not looking good.
One. Two.
There he goes.
Kicked out at two. Bruno is not going down that easily.
No.
Crowd's already loving it. Thrown back into the ring.
Back in the ring. Looks like who came back in the follow. Let's see what he's going to do here.
Okay. Ooh. Bruno stopped right there. Oh! Who's picked him up? Oh!
On the ropes.
One. Two. Three.
Yeah.
Who is still the continued 24/7 champion?
That's unfortunate. I do want to reiterate with those drop on the ropes. These are not just like ropes you put on boats. It is thick metal wire covered by rubber. That's all it is. So when you hit those, it hurts.
Let's go ahead and go on to the next match, that being a table match between Cheryl and Tess.
Ooh.
Now these
this
two.
This is an interesting rivalry.
Now these two, we haven't actually seen fight each other for a while, but we do know that Cheryl and you, Asheryl, have a little friendly rivalry going on right now. But y'all are more friends than rivals. Is that correct?
Yeah, it's hard to say. It's hard to explain right now. You know, Cheryl and I will always be friends. She'll always be a bestie, but. I'm not gonna lie. I'm still a little upset by what happened by that four-way. I felt like I did get targeted a lot by Cheryl, so
right.
Let's see how it plays out.
And a little bit of commentating from the chat section. Bruno is saying I'm overthinking what I could have done. Respect to who? That's some good sportsmanship on Bruno's side. Cheryl versus Seth, who do you think is going to win this, Joe?
This is an interesting matchup. I tell you what, you know, both I can't put my finger on, you know, like, they're both solid athletes, both solid wrestlers. Honestly, if I could say this is a draw, I would pick a draw. But if I had to pick one victor out of this match, I'm favoring Cheryl, because just look at her eyeballs compared to Tessa's eyeballs. I mean, you just see a fighter inside those eyeballs. And that's all I got to say.
I think it's just the eye makeup talking right there. But, you know, she is still a fighter.
Although,
but
so
Tess over here.
Tell me those aren't her eyeballs. Oh,
Tess
okay.
Over here.
Sorry.
For some reason, like, we don't know much about her, but we know that she can fight. Me and her have both fought over the last slice of pizza. And let me tell you, she will stop at nothing. She's an acrobat right there. So, let's go ahead and go on to this match. Let's see who's going to come out first.
Okay. So sorry about that.
We have no idea what you're
talking
about.
I had to step away for a moment. Our lovely backstage manager, Angel, was telling me he was leaving, so.
Oh, okay.
All good now. From Anaheim,
California. I mean, she is sprinting.
She is. She's got energy.
I mean, that's a record time.
Right in there.
Is that not... She was in the ring in less than 2.5 seconds.
And it seems like it is. I think that's the fastest she's ever come to the ring. This is the most energy I've seen out of Cheryl.
Oh, looks like Cheryl's mad.
She is pumped up for this match.
Now, if I can remember correctly, this is the first singles match, but Tess did target Cheryl a little bit with that fatal forward that we had. So.
Oh, yeah, a little bit. But now here comes Tess herself. Representing
the fallen from now, Australia, can we get an age confirmation on Tess?
Yeah, did we ever get that?
An age confirmation? What do you mean? Just like how old?
Yeah, age check,
she?
Like, yeah, how old is Tess here?
She looks 24 to 26.
Not at all. I would have to disagree.
No.
Okay, are we talking about her character or her actual self?
Okay, I'm talking about what I'm seeing on the screen right now.
The character.
Right.
You're telling
I can
me
see
she
the wrinkles.
24. Homie, she looks like she's 20 going on 80. All right.
Wow, all right, we're already up to a quick start here. Cheryl,
Cheryl already going after Tess.
Cheryl's got some anger.
Okay.
Showing some speed acrobatic. Oh, my God. Off the top rope. Back.
I mean, does Cheryl ever run out of stamina? No way.
Once again, Tess is already extremely hurt. So many flips. How many flips do we
finally reversal.
Reversal on Tess's part.
Did something happen backstage that we didn't see that's making Cheryl this mad at Tess?
Maybe performance-enhancing drugs. We might need to go check her locker after.
Tess has had some rivalry between you, Astral. Maybe because you and Cheryl are kind of teaming up. Maybe y'all are besties. It could be that. Oh, wait. What?
Is this? Who's this? Who might this be?
Astral, what are you doing?
Astral.
What are you doing in the ring?
What's going on here?
Astral. She just took off her headset and then just went into the ring. And now.
No way. Oh my goodness.
Her and Cheryl are going after Tess.
This isn't right.
Oh, right there. Just
a flip. Astral definitely gets what she deserves coming in late in this match. I mean, how are you going to team up what's going on here?
But now she's taking her attention away from
Cheryl. Tess is just doing some cartwheels and doing a flipperoonie. Here we go. Boom!
Meanwhile, Cheryl is using this distraction to get a table inside the ring.
Is finding a page out of Cheryl's playbook with the back. Oh my goodness, and
Cheryl is stunned. Astral is also stunned outside of the ring.
Let's go. Hello?
I think she just had a seizure.
Tess is just somehow found the strength to knock out both females in this fight.
She's trying to set up the table right now.
That's correct. This is a table match. Now, remind me once again, what do they need to do to win the match?
They need to throw their opponent through the table. First one to do that will win the match. Tess with the drop. Yeah, she did. Next time, don't.
Away Astral.
Hey.
Next time, maybe watch it. Like, you went in there trying to help your bestie.
You kind of just sabotaged Cheryl, if I'm being honest. I don't think.
I wanted Cheryl to have the upper hand.
Whoa! What a backflip reversal there.
Tess needs to get what she deserves. Again.
Pulling a play out of.
Ooh!
Bam! I mean, if we had to name that move right there, what would we name that? I mean, it looks like a scorpion circle.
No idea.
Cheryl's just killing it with the backflips. I mean, we obviously know you're a gymnast. Like, Cheryl's something else.
On the
finger guns. I'm coming right for you, she said.
Top rope. And no, she just drops down.
And she decided against it. Ooh,
what's happening here? Cheryl is the winner here.
Cheryl is our winner. See, I had trust in my best friend. I knew she was going to get it.
Here is your winner, the Super.
Yup. Look at my girl go. Cheryl deserves it. Tess has messed with too many people. Exactly. Don't fuck with the she shed. And that's the amazing thing, is even without me coming in, I knew Cheryl would have won it, but Tess has been running her mouth for way too long, and I just felt like Cheryl needed a buddy.
Alright, well, it's time that me and Lyrics actually
look
take on a match of ourselves. Now, me and Lyrics have been kind of a little heated lately, but...
Yeah, I'm not sure why they're teaming up here. This is strange to me. Interesting matchup.
Yeah,
like,
it is an interesting
think about
one.
It. Think about how last week ended. I mean, these two were screaming their heads off at each other. Now they're teaming up together? What's the story behind that?
So the story behind that, I was actually told this last minute that if me and Lyrics are going to just try... they're telling us that we have to try to get along, and they're basically forcing us to do it with this match. I don't like it. I don't like the logic behind it, but that's what they're going with. Now, Lyrics here is, Lyrics is the top Spartan champion. He holds a belt, but, I do have to respect him for that. But now we're pretty much being forced to tag team here. My usual tag team partner is Tess, but this is how it's going to be for now.
Yeah, but who cares about Tess right now?
Okay. Anyway, guys, I'll be out behind the stage getting ready. I'll see y'all in a bit.
All right, so it looks like it'll be me
and
commentator Joe.
That's correct. Yeah, not
so
sure about
that. Who do you think's going to take it in this match?
I mean, I'm hoping for my boy Lyrics and Knight. That's as simple as I can get it, but I'm still just confused. I mean, they're yelling each other's heads off.
We have clips of it.
Yeah,
you could hold out anything.
Yeah, head back to the backstage. I'll see you back there in a few minutes, dog.
That was crazy.
Correct. I slightly think that Knight here is just wanting to get a piece of the victory action and teaming up with Lyrics here. I don't think the Comatose management, or by any means... I don't think they're forcing him to team up with Lyrics here. I still think there's bad blood here, and if they lose tonight, that might be the storyline.
Yeah, they could easily turn back on each other just after this. I mean, the thing about wrestling is you never really know what happens until the match happens. So.
Correct.
Very interested to see. I think all four of the guys are good competitors. I think it's going to be a really good tornado tag match. It's going to be a lot of chaos and action in the ring. Because, I will reiterate, in case, I'm sure most know, but in case don't, tornado tag means that it doesn't have to be one-on-one in the ring. It is everyone. So it is going to be complete chaos. I figured us saying, excited to see this match would have...
Correct. And I couldn't have said it better myself. Many other sayings we have said. Anyways, let's see who comes out first here.
All right. Very pretty lights. Very bright.
The one. the only lyrics coming out.
Yeah,
you gotta show off that belt.
Oh yeah, our current champion. He really worked to get that belt, man.
Absolutely.
Also, you know, I love the Houston boy. We'd love to see it.
Correct. Out of Houston. Letting him have his moment. Hearing the fans roar. I mean, he's really built up his reputation here in this 3 weeks of comatose.
Oh, yeah.
Just walking out to the ring.
He's definitely proven himself. That's why he has the belt. I mean, you know, he definitely showed up.
I noticed from week one to week two, he changed his fit. Did he change his fit once again? It looks about the same, but you never know what's underneath that sweater.
That is true. It could be something different. I do, honestly, I like the changing looks. I think the more he changes as a wrestler and the more he's becoming a champion, he's changing the look with the personality, and I feel like that really fits out.
I agree. Couldn't have said it better myself.
Look at me. I did the same. Tess pissed me off. I got mad, and now I have a whole better look. Like,
absolutely.
Amazing. All right, here comes Knight.
Knight looking like he's keeping the same look in week three.
Yeah.
He's pumped up. He's finally part of a winning team here. Now, keep in mind, Knight here is undefeated in tag team matches, but in the singles match, he hasn't yet to win a match. So he's looking to continue his reputation of being undefeated in tag team, as well as Lyrix. Because Lyrix and Bruno also are undefeated in tag team matches as well. Oh, Lyrix
is
out there getting warmed up.
Yeah. Gotta get that energy in. Gotta be ready.
Absolutely.
He definitely looks somewhat ready.
Lyrix already has his shirt up. Ooh, what an entrance here. The plyometrics.
The lights are red. He comes out. Scorpion.
And if this doesn't look like a villain, I don't know what will.
For sure.
I wonder how the fans are going to react to seeing a Mortal Kombat player hop into the comatose world.
I definitely think it's a good crossover.
Not bad.
Our manager definitely got some good brand deals. Doing a little Forbidden Door action. Bringing in other people.
Forbidden what? I couldn't quite hear you. Maybe we should say that. No. Actually. And then his partner. Last but not least.
Yeah.
Sub-Zero coming out.
Ooh, we got the spotlight.
For the final member of this match. Is he yawning? Was that a yawn just that? Is he?
That kind of looks like it.
Looks like he might be adjusting his mask there. Not quite sure there.
Definitely taking his wrist guards.
Definitely looks confident.
Oh,
definitely
yeah.
Knows what
he's
knows what he's doing
walk.
Here.
He's ready to fight. He knows. Ooh, an easy step over the ropes. This man is just full of confidence.
He's got to be huge. How tall is this guy?
I'm
making sure,
sure
the ropes are warmed up.
Right. Definitely taller than Knight, but you know, then again, a lot of people are, so.
Ooh.
I heard that.
I mean, you're not wrong. Here's Lyrix and Knight, Sub-Zero, and Scorpion. Who's going to step in the ring first? Are they all? Oh, they're all going at it. Okay.
Yeah, like I said, it's every man in the ring.
Got it.
All right, so it looks like Lyrix is going against Sub-Zero.
Absolutely.
Putting him over the rope.
Knight currently manhandling Scorpion. Wow, what a hit there by Knight. I think his presence fell.
Yeah.
Ooh. Lyrix, go ahead and flex on him a little bit more there. Get that
Knight
camera time.
Like he's kind of playing, you know, back and forth with Scorpion, but he eventually knocked him down.
I mean, the clear front runners at the moment. I spoke too soon. A reversal out of Sub-Zero.
Yeah. Ooh. Knight still got the upper hand, though. He's definitely putting some shots on Scorpion. Ooh, I spoke too soon.
Sub-Zero going to Pound Town. Scorpion lands a passive on Knight. Oh, I need the face, the Lyrix.
Oh my gosh.
What's going on?
Am I late? You did miss a couple matches, but honestly, you came to a good one, so.
Oh, the pin on Knight gets the two already.
Ooh.
Scorpion can't believe it. Lyrix too busy. I am Sub-Zero. He needs to realize what's going on to his teammate.
Right.
Knight is in danger.
Lurks is just focused on his opponent.
Ooh, Lurks showing his strength.
Yup.
Give it 360, why don't you?
Ooh. Oh, that kick.
Lurks with the pin. This could be massive. One. Not at all. Never mind. That's all I can count to.
Oh, looks like Scorpion wants to.
What a reversal.
Hit Lurks.
Stick to your own person, Lurks says. Or I'll handle the both of you. Spiritual knee there. He did that the last time in his first match.
Yeah. Oh, looks like Knight's getting some punches in. Knocks up there to the ground.
They switch partners. This is going well for Lyrics and Knight.
It is.
And I spoke too soon yet again. Wow.
Looks like.
Do I have the commentator
up the upper hand?
Wait, Knight's got a pin. This referee can't get to him, though.
No, Scorpion was blocking him.
What's. Oh, snap. Ooh.
Right,
he's going for a pin here, perhaps?
Ooh.
He's got Sub-Zero in a scorpion-like pose. The irony there.
Yeah.
Knight is just bullying that guy in the corner. There's a pin by Lyrics. Canceled by Scorpion.
Yeah, but they were right there too soon.
Oh!
Ooh, Knight's got reversed by pin, though.
Only gets the one, though. I mean, I think still clearly the winners of this match so far have been Knight and Lyrics. They've just continued to go for the pin, but just haven't been able to get it to three.
Oh, yeah. It looks like Sub-Zero is struggling a little bit. If they can just get him down a little more and get the pin, Knight
absolutely.
And Lyrics could have this.
Oh, they're tag teaming on him. Knight just throwing haymakers, but missed every single one. Oh, my goodness.
Ooh,
what a body slam by Lyrics.
Sub-Zero's like
just struggling
Scorpion.
In the corner.
Yeah. Ooh. Scorpion
just
kick out of it. Out of the corner.
Dominating.
Knight's got to get the upper hand. Ooh. Looks like Knight almost threw Scorpion onto Lyrics. That could have been an interesting
There's a pin
one.
Behind the... There's a pin right behind them! And the referee is completely ignoring them! Hello? Hey, actually, what a win there by Knight and Lyrics.
But Knight got that submission, so they did win.
I couldn't tell if Lyrics got pinned to three or if Knight won that by submission, but it was too close to call, and the referee called that Knight and Lyrics win that. What a match.
I mean, hey, the ref makes the call. It's their job.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Can't agree with the ref. Lyrics remains undefeated in the Comatose universe. Knight is also undefeated in his tag team matches. What a match.
Knight
Let's
has
bring in
the
Knight.
Biggest like neck vein strain right now on that like screenshot.
Looks like he's yelling at a hater in the stands.
Okay.
I wonder what he's
it
thinking.
Might be.
Okay.
Welcome Dang. Back, Knight.
Thank you. Thank you.
How are you feeling after that match?
I feel good. It would have been great, you know, if I could have just stayed on Scorpion. But either way, you know, I still made him tap out. But yeah, you know, I just feel like that I could have done a little bit more better than my performance out there. But hey, you know what? Still came out on top.
Absolutely. I mean. It to me, it looked like you did a phenomenal job. I don't see what you could have done better. I mean, there was a few moments where you just got hit and your defense was lacking. But I mean, overall, I feel like that was as good as it could have gotten.
I'm just glad that the ref was a little dumb into being blind to see that Sub-Zero was pinning my partner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it was as clear as day on the camera view. I don't know what the people in the stands saw, but that's
unfortunate. The ref got to pick one, and I guess he just maybe he wanted Knight to win. Maybe Knight and the ref have something going on in the back locker room, some deal we don't know about.
I'm still here. I don't know what you're talking. Like I'm not here.
And we'll be right back.
And right here we have G versus Kratos. G in his Dante persona. Going up against the God of War, Kratos.
Yeah, I was confused on what you were saying there. Didn't see G, but that makes sense.
This is his persona in Comatose. He is Dante from Devil May Cry.
Okay, I respect it completely. I mean, he took the mask off from what he appeared like last week. I mean, if you don't remember, we're gonna throw it on the Jumbotron here. I mean, look at G coming in here, sneaking behind.
Are we?
Trevor. Are we? I guess our management's not that great on week three of Comatose. We'll get that sorted out.
Yeah, it looks like they might be setting the Titanotron up for the next people's intros, so we'll come back to it. But no, if you do remember
like
from that week,
a new budget.
We do.
He
we
did
do
pop
need
out. It was very interesting. It's nice to see an unmasking of G.
Let's get this started.
Comatose Wrestling is taking place in my bedroom on my PlayStation 5.
Let's get
do you remember, we can also commentate, you know, during their intros.
Absolutely. I mean, all right, who's coming out first?
First one out. It's going to be
Dante, okay.
Dante, the son of Spartan.
Making his way to the
ring. All right. That's a very interesting haircut.
Yeah, it looks like he put a little bit too much gel, but that could be me sitting way far back over here. I can't really see too close to him, but
possibly. I see what you're getting at, but I mean, you know, if they're moving around, you gotta have the hair stay. So
that's true.
I get
you
it.
Think that's his real hair, or
I think it is.
Looks like the
Man,
same
that
entrance
hair is
as
not moving.
Sub-Zero, I think it was last match. Yeah, it's not moving at all. It's pretty stiff. As well as his back. He looks kind of stiff here. I wonder if he's injured from last week after the beat-up he got from Trevor and Kratos. Wait, now that I think about it, G did make an appearance in the tag team match with Bruno and Lyrix versus Kratos and Trevor.
That's true. And it made
Kratos
them lose. Who's coming out right now?
I'm getting news that there was...
It's G.
Yeah, and now Kratos is seeking revenge on G. He remembers this person, even unmasked.
Right,
Kratos is seeking revenge.
This could be interesting to see how this plays out, because this could be more anger in Kratos. It could be, you know, more power, more energy. I mean, if Kratos wants something, he usually gets it.
Absolutely. I mean, right off the bat, if I had to pick a winner, it goes 100% to Kratos. I mean, not a shadow of a doubt makes me think that G is going to win it. I mean, no offense, G, if you are in the stands watching, but, I mean, Kratos is just seeking blood.
Kratos is coming in, masked, just demanding the attention. Demanding for people to see the downfall of G.
He hasn't had much time in the ring. Also, you got to remember, last week was his first appearance, and he just got obliterated.
This is technically
and
his
look at
debut.
Us getting some screen time in the background. Hey, folks, I'm on TV.
This is technically his debut match.
Correct. This is officially
going off. Let's see.
And we're up
already. Kratos throwing Dante G. To the corner of the ring.
What should we call it? G or Dante?
Jonte
getting beat up early. I mean, Kratos just manhandling Dante, G Dante.
Right at the top of the turnbuckle. Already being held up against there.
No breathing, bro.
Man, Kratos. Go ahead.
You're good. I said, for some reason, my headset lost sound, and I could not hear the match or commentary. So
these are production team. I mean, they're just hooking us up with the cheapest quality headsets out tonight. I mean,
I think we're gonna have to have a team meeting after this show, boys.
Absolutely.
All right, we'll have
G finally gets some breathing room and lands a brutal hit on Kratos.
Remember, this is a tables match, so the first one to throw their opponent...
Three kicks to the body by Kratos.
First one to throw their opponent through the table will win the match.
Yeah.
G finally making his presence known.
This match.
And yet again with another 5-6 punches to the face.
Ooh.
Kratos might not be feeling too good down there.
Yeah.
G!
Already, Kratos' torso is injured.
Oh, Kratos is a beast, but G may actually be the one to put him away.
Ooh. That's gotta hurt.
You have
back.
A commentator curse.
I think so. You gotta be careful what we'd say. There's one knee, there's two knees, and just tosses him off to the ring.
His ankle seemed to hit that table. I bet that hurts, man.
I was about to say, this is a tables match, like Knight said earlier. And there it is.
So far, it is an even match. And already, could this be it? That's it!
And G just wins like that.
Just like that,
he
G
says,
wins.
Thank you very much, Kratos, for setting up my table. And just slams him in.
That's all he needed.
Wow.
G has beaten Kratos.
Dante with a win over Kratos. Kratos, I mean, I think he just got fired up too early on and lost his stamina there.
Yeah.
I mean,
Dante,
yeah,
what a win. And
they're both son
Kratos
of Sparta, so.
Really thought Kratos was going to like kick out of that or reversal somewhat. I mean,
right.
Next we have
possibly push him away.
Tempura versus Kermit the Frog.
Ooh. This
there
could
it
be an interesting one.
This could be an interesting
I agree.
No.
Now, we're talking about strength. Tim clearly wins, but this is a submission match.
Exactly.
And Kermit is a lot more agile. So you got to keep aware, keep in mind who's going to be on the floor more.
Kent still could have the upper hand, but he's definitely got to watch out, because Kermit is small, and usually, you know, the smaller, faster people tend to get better submissions.
That's true.
Absolutely.
It's not so
but
much
you
the gotta
powerhouse. Remember, Kermit the Frog is 0-2 right now.
Yeah, I was just about to touch on that. Correct me if I'm wrong, though, but both of these fighters are winless, correct?
That is correct.
So I believe both of them are seeking their first ever win in Comatose Wrestling.
Hey, that means that nobody here can be a loser except for me in the singles match.
Where it is, I'm getting some voices in my head. The production team telling me we should run some gambling. Oh!
Oh, okay.
Gambling. You want to do some? Okay, let's do it.
We're kind of late into the night, but absolutely, production, we will get a hold of that. Yes, sir.
Yeah, we can do that for sure.
Okay.
Let's I will handle it. Don't worry, fellow commentators.
Get this started.
All right. Thank you, Joe. All right, we're going to get the match started. Joe is setting up the gambling bets.
Who's coming out first?
It looks like Temp's coming out.
The following contest is a submission. Tempura out here promising his fans to not let them down.
Yep. I'm going for Temp. I mean, Kermit's good, but
Temp has power.
If you've seen the way Temp wrestles these past couple weeks, he is a beast. So
look at that.
I have no doubt that I think he'd get it.
Entering over the top rope, just stepping over it. Just a tower of a man.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. I mean, I think he gets his inspiration maybe from the Big Show. I mean, slight resemblance. Very slight.
I see a little resemblance.
Look-wise, yes. Performance-wise, absolutely not.
No. And coming in next, we have Kermit the Frog.
Here's Kermit. The internet.
Ooh, Kermit's coming quick. He's ready.
You know, despite Kermit not winning any matches yet, he does come out with a lot of energy week after week. And I've got to show respect where it's due.
Oh, yeah, it's admirable to see.
Absolutely.
He
must be getting paid fairly well. Unless, the passion just might just be there. I mean, just getting the voices in my head against. No fighters are currently under contract. Oh, okay, got it. So they're all fighting for free.
Yes, they are. Of their own free will.
Got it. And then we're off. Tempura absolutely slams Kermit to the ground already. Like I said, the strength is there. My goodness.
I didn't know a man that big can actually flip.
And if you notice there, it looked like a leapfrog on a Kermit the Frog. I mean, wow.
The irony.
A submission. The irony there. We already got a submission going on early on. Kermit Reverses out of that.
Kermit is out here just trying to do something, but he could obviously see the power difference between the two.
Absolutely. Kermit, don't know if he was playing dead there or if he wanted. Oh! Couldn't even finish my thought there. That looked absolutely devastating from Tim.
Off the top rope.
Off the top ropes. My goodness.
Temp over here hoping to break the ring.
Surprised Kermit's skull is still attached to his spine. Fatal blows here. I mean, this could end someone's life.
Ooh.
Somehow Kermit finds a reversal though. Not anymore.
This might be just a oh, there it goes.
There's a reversal.
Sweet.
Stepping on his fingers. Ooh, that's gotta hurt his fingers.
Kermit
it has
some
to. I mean,
damage to the torso.
Ooh. There we go, Kermit. Absolutely
misses
on that backflip though.
Yeah. Temp got out of the way quick. He knows what he's doing.
Temp is getting mad now. Ooh.
Absolutely devastating blow. What jab there? Reversal from Kermit.
Kick.
Now a kick. Now another kick to the face.
Oh, right in. Okay.
The midsection.
Midsection. Ooh. Thank you.
Yep. He's got to be quick with it.
Somehow, some way, Kermit is just getting up and up after each of these devastating blows.
Oh, yeah.
A drop kick.
Ooh,
out of
the ground.
Right off the apron onto the ground. Tempura is just waiting.
Teasing him.
Yeah.
Go ahead and get up, he says.
Tip pumps him up.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Oh, what a move. Kermit showing no quit yet. Is this a submission? Is this allowed outside the ring?
It is allowed outside the ring. Yes, it is.
As long as it's a submission, they can count it.
Tim clearly exits that submission.
Oh, yeah. He's not ready yet.
You know, despite this being an absolutely, blow for blow match out of these two, this is a submission match, and we've only seen one this far. You got to get more on the ground or get submissions going on, or else no one's going to come out victorious.
Yep.
There's two signs in the stand that say, tag me in. I'd rather see them. No, just kidding. Kermit showing some fight. Misses that, whatever that move is called.
I just want to point out the size difference, like the height between Temp and Kermit, too.
Oh,
that
for
is
sure.
It definitely
That's
is.
How Kermit's getting some of those high punches. I mean, he has to jump to get up there.
It's definitely a match of speed versus strength here, but strength seems to be coming out on top.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, clearly. Clearly.
I mean, he's got to put that strength into getting a submission at some point, too.
For sure. Speaking of submissions, looks like he's trying to get him in the right position in the middle of the ring. Tim just...
Tim's kind of riling him up a little bit. They're trying to get him up.
Circling up to see the best angle he can
approach. Here we go. This could be it. This could be it.
We got
I mean, how do you get that
Kermit,
man off of you? I don't see Kermit exiting still, this anytime soon.
No. I,
that's,
I think he's got
is
it.
That, no, it's not it.
Kermit,
it's not it.
Kermit's reversing. He's getting out.
Well, I spoke too soon.
Kermit has some heart here.
Absolutely.
He's not giving up that easily.
But you also got to do remember, Kermit also does have a hurt torso and a slightly hurt head, so it could still slow him down.
Correct. I mean, Kermit just needs to put him on the floor once more.
Right.
Go. Oh.
Ooh.
Gets, oh. Gets him on the floor, Kermit. This is your chance. Don't mess around. He takes a knee to the knuckle. Mm. Oh,
spear. Jinx.
We've seen that plenty of times.
Surprised.
Is this a submission? There's no way.
No.
Kermit has him in a chokehold. Tim fighting for his life.
Oh,
it wasn't enough.
And he gets out.
Nope.
Woo! Tim breathing a sigh of relief.
Kermit's still getting those. Ooh, Tim's reversing those punches. Tim's got to get the upper hand. He could do this.
Turn him on the ropes. And flipped over the top
over the
rope.
My
Tim
goodness.
Is out of the ring.
This guy, Kermit, He's got strength where I didn't even know it was possible.
I know.
Where's he? Where's all his muscles?
I don't know. Like, I
mean, clearly he has some. Oh! Temp rolls out of the way just in time.
Yeah, he went for Fox Splash and he missed.
Stunned. Let's see.
As agile as frogs are, I mean, surprised he didn't learn that. Oh, snap. This is a tight hold.
Is Kermit going to tap out? Is he going to get out of it?
Looks like.
No, not it.
No way. Kermit survives yet another tight submission by Tempura.
Ooh.
Gets Tempura on the ground, though.
Corkscrew.
Another spear.
Jinx.
He's got this Tempura stunned. This is the moment.
Yeah.
He's got a headlock.
This could be submission after submission.
Who can hold out the longest?
Absolutely.
Temp definitely got to think of something.
At this rate, I don't know who's going to win. I mean, at first I thought Tempura was going to clearly take this, but it looks like they're both struggling on submitting each other.
Oh, yeah. And Tempura looks like he's bleeding.
How did he just do that?
He must have hit the buckle that hard because Temp is now bleeding.
What a move by Kermit. I mean,
down on the ground.
First picks him up on top. Wait, is Tempura bleeding?
Tempura is bleeding, like I mentioned. He started bleeding when he hit the turnbuckle.
Bleeding from a frog.
Frog is throwing Tempura around like he's nothing.
Oh, he is.
It's like he's him.
Waiting for Tempura to get up.
Told him to get up. Wow, what a move. Puts Tempura on the ground yet again. The backflip actually lands this time. Kermit is clearly showing that he's the better fighter in these last few moments.
Temp is trying to turn it around.
Second. He turns around indeed. Slams Kermit on the floor.
Waiting for Kermit to get
ready.
Back.
He wants to hit him again. Backbreaker onto the ground.
Kermit is stunned right now. Let's see. Rope break. Rope break.
Yeah.
Caught a break there by the rope, literally.
He needed to move into the
so
middle.
So far, the crowd
got
is loving it. Oh, but Tempura is getting on the top rope. Oh.
A man that big should not be flying from that high. I'll say it. I'll be the first to say it.
It's scientifically impossible, but he's doing it.
Tempura. Getting riled up. He puts his hand in the sky.
You can't see me.
We've seen this before.
Oh, no, those jumbles! Oh!
He's doing the elbow, too. This Temp is legendary. This man is just...
I mean, getting word that Tempura was trained by the man, John Cena himself.
No way!
He was.
That explains a lot of his strengths.
I mean, it would be devastating to be trained by John Cena and still lose a match afterwards, no? I mean... Come on, with a man of that size?
Why do you think he's like been going at it for so long now? He's not going to
give up.
That's
a fair point. You know, John Cena always put on a show.
I am getting word from our media that this so far has been the highest rated match that we've had tonight.
That is amazing.
That is correct. Oh, wait, hold up. Kermit's got a chokehold on Tempura. Is Tempura going to tap out?
No, he's not.
Not yet. I think both these guys are just exhausted. I don't see how much longer this will go on. Tip and Kermit still showing.
Kermit just completely missed that. But here we go.
That is unfortunate. Kermit misses it and instantly put into a submission. If this is the final moments, Kermit's going to regret that move.
Could be close.
Somehow survives. Tempura's got to tighten his shoes there. Got a little loose.
Wait for him to get up.
And Temp taking a current breather here. They both need to catch their breath over this long match.
Ooh, on the head.
Oh my. Two back-to-back hits to the head.
And back up. Attitude adjustment. Stunned. Going at it again. Let's see. Could this be it?
I mean, we've said it all match. If I had a pick, I would say no, but let's prove me wrong, please.
No, it is not.
Of course.
It does look like Kenta's getting some of his energy and strength back. I'm not sure I can say the same about Kermit.
Not at the moment. Nope.
Ooh.
Wait, what is going on here? Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Ooh.
Wait a second. Whoa. Was that a fake hurt by Kermit? He just hops over his shoulders.
It might have been.
Okay.
I don't know what that was.
All right, Kermit.
Hold on, let me check the script.
Kermit,
yeah, that was supposed to happen. He's ad-libbing now.
Though.
Kermit is the most hurt despite you can't see me.
Can't see me.
Despite Tempura bleeding from the top. Five knuckle shuffle. Oh.
Let me do it again.
Kermit is out of it. Attempt to
Hey, you stunned. Oh my goodness.
That has to be the fourth stun this match.
That's got to be the moment of this match. If he can submit him here, that would be quite impressive. Now we have a.
This is a very good match. This is 5 stars so far, people.
Yeah, media is telling me it's a 5-star match, guys. This is insane. And they're still going.
Another spear.
This has to be the fifth one now.
Top rope.
Tempura is stunned. Oh,
what a backflip.
Another splash.
Another backflip.
He connects at this time. Kermit's got the chance. He needs to stop fooling around and get a submission if he wants to win this.
I agree.
Oh,
what a combo there by Kermit. I mean, absolutely devastating blows to Tim. Struggling now. I mean, this is just a back and forth and back and forth match. I don't see a clear winner as of yet.
No, I'm not either.
Oh!
Tempura is stunned once again. Bring him back up. Spear!
Another spear.
Kermit loves the spear.
Where's Kermit getting all the spears from?
Here it goes.
He must have learned from his first match against Lyrics. He did get speared and taken down, if you don't remember. Wait a second. Could this be it?
No!
No.
Of course it isn't. You, in the crowd, get in the ring, he says.
Trying to get the crowd pumped up.
He's getting that little, I think he put it to that little boy there. You see that little boy?
Yeah, the
not quite sure what that little boy would do. Oh, wait, we got a new submission hold here. This could be different. He's got him right around with his legs.
Oh, he's flailing around.
Now, this would be absolutely amazing.
Not it.
Not even the frog legs could get him the win.
Frog splash.
Yeah, how fitting.
All
right. Kermit just abusing Tim at this point. I mean, Tim don't think he just wants to fight anymore. He just wants this over.
Off
Kermit
the
off the top ropes, a backflip.
In reversal, he got his knees up just in time.
Reversal.
See, and that's the thing I've noticed is Kermit has Tim down, but instead of going to a submission, he tends to do a couple of different moves first, and that almost gives Tim time to rest.
Another spear.
That's got to be 5 for the match, but I'm not counting. Who's keeping track out there?
I think that one was number 6.
You know,
I have not counted, but maybe I should have.
One thing I've noticed with each submission hold, if this is not the one, let's take a listen here. It's not. Wow. If you notice, the referee was behind Tempura and Kermit. I think the refs are having a hard time really getting in a good placement for any of these matches. I mean, that's just my point of view, or that's my opinion. But it just looks as that way.
Yeah, remind me to send the refs back to school, man.
And I agree. Kermit's still toying with him.
Ooh.
Got him on the ground, looking for submission. No, gets
him back another
spear. A spear. My goodness.
Here we
Kermit
go.
Showing that he's learned a new move.
Now, Tim just reaches over for the rope. It could be
a
rope break.
Yeah,
he could grab, but I mean,
he's got to do
Kermit
is lift
may
the
have
finger.
Him in a position where he can't really get up.
Oh, right there. Giving Tim enough time to actually make a comeback. Here we go. Oh. You can't see me. Five knuckle shuffle.
something about that move. Oh. I mean, no big man should be able to move like that. I mean, he just makes it look too easy.
Hey, I mean, it is Temp.
It is Temp, indeed. Kermit is now stunned.
Got Kermit in the corner.
Placed on the top rope.
Takes him to the top rope.
Oh.
Back over there.
A jab. Stay up here. Get on my shoulder, boy.
Up on the shoulders.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Temp.
That looks like it also hurt Temp as well as it hurt Kermit.
Here we go.
We're able to get up there. All right. There's a submission. We haven't seen one from Temp in a while.
Yeah, this could be it.
I mean, you're telling me a man with those size muscles can't choke this little frog?
It's not over yet! Look at this crowd cheering!
This is possibly the longest match we've had, too.
Longest match we've had so far.
There's no doubt about it.
Each man is just not done. Tep is over the ropes.
Almost
falls
over. Ooh. Oh, and there he goes.
He's not stunned yet, so he is still in it.
Yep.
They're both catching their breath here.
Oh, what is Kermit doing?
Oh my God! Is Kermit on?
He's thinking about
Kermit's
it.
On the top rope.
Where is he? He's pointing inside the ring. Now he's there. Ooh. He goes.
Ooh.
Letting Temp catch his breath a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, Kermit! Nice reversal to the body, to the leg, to
Temp
the face.
Stunned.
To the face, to the leg, to the face, ooh, to the face. Wait a second. Oh, I thought Kermit was going to put him in a submission with the leg. I think
every
their weakness is obviously going for that choke submission. They got to mix things up.
See, now the thing with this match is that you have to make your opponent submit. But he also has to have access for his arms to tap on the ground. So that's probably the best one that there is.
Yeah.
Possibly the only one.
There's Temp showing some fight late in this match.
Not done yet.
Ooh. Boom. I mean, those body slams look like they could end Kermit's life.
Oh, yeah.
Think of the body slams.
Another one.
I'm surprised Kermit still has a spine.
Third one?
Another
there
one.
There is. I mean, you caught it.
That is a suplex on the ground, man.
And onto the wall. Kermit is stunned, standing up. Is that another slam?
I think these fans are have.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh, into the ring post.
Ramming his head into the ring post. Kermit is still stunned, and Tempura
is
emphasizing on this as much as possible.
Temp is fighting. Tired of fighting outside the ring. Just kidding. He goes back outside to meet Kermit.
Ooh.
And that was a mistake because Kermit just went a reversal. He's going to step on his toes, or his fingers rather. Ooh.
This is an insane match.
I clearly did not expect this match to go this long. I mean,
I did not either.
Neither did production.
It was going to be a one and done, but
production did not see this either.
Yeah, production's getting a little hectic in the back, but hey, it's a 5-star match. People are wanting to see it, so we keep it going.
Absolutely. Is this a permission here? Can it happen outside the ring?
No, it doesn't look like it.
Will it happen?
Looks like we got some yelling from the crowd from G saying, when is enough? I don't know. This match should go on forever, man.
The willpower of both of these competitors is insane.
Now, realistically, how much longer can this match last?
I don't think it can last much longer. I think both of the men are very probably tired at this point.
Can the ref call this off as a, you know, DQ at some point, or, you know, no winner? All right, what's going on? I mean, neither of them are showing like they can submit one another. Here they go yet
going
again.
Back and forth.
Yeah.
Fighting it off.
Tip's getting some head slam.
And already reversal by Kermit. Oh, head slam.
Kermit's got to go for submission. But instead he gets him up.
Another spear.
Because he wants to spear him. That's a record-setting spear there.
Temp just grabbed the rope It's right there. Just grab the rope, Temp.
Don't grab the rope. Please, just end the match. Please, right. let's go. I'll go home.
Let's just let it go. We got too many more matches to come.
After this, I think it's just one more match.
Him still bleed.
Another spear. I think that makes 8 now.
Yeah.
Sorry about that, folks. Oh, snap. Tempura yet again in a chokehold.
Yep.
That's it.
Temp finally tapped out.
It's about time. Kermit gets his first victory in Komotoad. Tempura is still winless. A French Paradox. What a nickname. Or a Paradox, rather. What a nickname there.
What a name.
Kermit. I mean, look at Temp. Is he dead?
Knocked out on the floor.
Is he breathing out there? Can we get the paramedics out here?
Hey, paramedics, can we get some medics out here? Now, this is our main event match right here, people. This
main
is
event of the evening.
Top female Spartan. The top female Spartan match for the belts. We have Astral versus Tifa. Now, Astral, we see that you came out here with a new outfit today.
I did. I got a whole new personality, man. I was getting treated bad as, you know, the Wii Fit trainer. I felt like I was being underlooked. You know?
Absolutely.
This is my moment, this is my time to shine, and this is my championship belt.
Alright.
So I have to turn, that's what I'll do.
Okay, we see that Astral is becoming a pretty much a heel at this point. Trying to become the number one female Spartan in this series.
You know what? And I'm proud of it because we need a better wrestler on this woman's roster.
Oh,
just touch Cheryl. Just touch Cheryl. Cheryl's great.
Fire.
But everyone else, it's time, man. Y'all about to get defeated.
All right. Well, let's go ahead and get. We'll let you go ahead and get backstage for you to get started. All right.
Yep. I'm gonna go warm up. I will see y'all after.
See you after. Okay. So now we have Astral versus Tifa. Now Tifa has been our reigning champion for top female Spartan belt, but now Astral seems that she is ready to go in and take it all for herself. What do you think about that, Joe?
Sorry, I was getting some audio frequencies that I couldn't hear there. Could you repeat that, please?
What do you think about Astral going against Tifa for top female Spartan belt?
I mean, it's poetic. I mean, you know, last week, you know, Astral takes the was it Money in the Bank? Correct me if I'm wrong, correct?
That is correct.
Yeah, I mean, coming off of that, I mean, 1v3 action, clearly showing that she's the top of the top female fighters of this group. And yeah, I mean, it's poetic. If she can win this fight, I mean, a 2-time world champion already in Komotoad, that'd be the first of its kind.
Absolutely, that would be quite a record to hold. So let's go ahead and get this started.
Oh wow. Who could this be? All right. I'm guessing that happens before title matches, and here comes Astral.
Here she is.
Absolutely.
Badass.
Fighter in her eyes.
She is ready. She's ready to fight. She's trying to conserve her energy right now. Because, you know, she can't just waste it all. She's going against a champ.
Of course. Champ for a reason. She is not going to take no for an answer.
Going up the stairs. She is ready. You can see the fierce in her eyes. She wants that belt. And she is ready. Now, we saw her earlier tonight interrupting the match between Cheryl and Tess, helping Cheryl out and making Test lose.
So we're and now, her opponent, the champ, for a reason. Now, remind me, who did Tifa take the belt from?
She did take it from Tess. It was more of a ladder match than anything.
Got it.
Nobody was a champion, but she was going up against Tess for the championship belt. At the end of it, it was fine. You know, they're good friends, but, you know, somebody had to become the champ.
And absolutely.
One way to decide that if nobody was, it was to be a ladder match.
Got it. Forgot about that. Yeah, Tess, you know, since her championship match losing that, she hasn't seemed too confident in her fighting abilities. But here we go.
Here we go.
Championship match.
The main event of the night.
Introducing the champion from Osaka, Japan, she's the Honor Champion, the Superstar.
The Tifa, Superstar.
Tifa Lockhart, everybody.
Giving that belt right over to the ref, knowing what's up for, what's at stake.
Taking one last good look at it, and she's seeing what she could win. Putting it way up high.
Now, this is the same ref from every single previous match we've had so far. So yeah, if something fishy happens, I'm going to point my finger at that guy.
We're going to see. We're going to see.
And let's get this underway.
Already, who's at top? So far, Astral is already going in.
What a fatal elbow already.
Oh.
Tifa hanging on for dear life. Ooh. Doesn't even matter.
Now, Astral here is already showing so much power right off the bat.
Absolutely. That's gotta hurt the elbow.
Giving the champ a what for?
Another blow to the other arm. Astral showing no signs of quitting just yet. My goodness.
Already.
Tifa can't even catch a breath.
Tifa cannot catch up.
Astral off the top ropes. Lands right on the neck. That's got to hurt. I mean, I don't know how Tifa's still breathing. Wait a second. There's a reversal.
No, wasn't enough. Oh, wait, it was. Here it is.
Tifa with a reversal?
No.
Ooh, not even a one count, though. Astral clearly not even dazed yet in this fight. It's not going to work.
It's like Tifa's slammed
by Astral.
Gain consciousness to get back, but she's already hurting in the torso.
Absolutely stunned.
Here it is.
Here comes
one,
a pin.
Two.
One.
Two.
Kicks out of that one.
Wasn't enough.
It wasn't Astral enough. Jade.
Surprise.
You know what? I think I do not realize why I look different tonight. Marry me, I'm single in the stand. Latifah's showing some fight here.
I don't think I look different.
Wait. Why do you have a wig?
Don't worry about that.
Anyways, back to the fight here. Ooh. Tifa now on top. Sorry, we got distracted there, folks. Co-commentator has a wig on for some reason, but Astral is showing some fight with the reversal. Ouch. Now, what kind of match is this? I completely forgot. Is this just an anything?
A no holds bar match.
And now, remind me what that means.
It means that they could do whatever they need to in order to win.
Roger. Oh, snap. Astral showing some confidence with her hair.
Oh, but here we go. Astral is stunned. Keep it going. One, two. Was it enough? Wow. Out on the two. We got a three-star match here.
I have to admit, I am surprised Astral kicked out of that one.
Same. She was stunned.
She was stunned. I mean, completely blindsided from that kick. I just don't know how she found the breath to do so. But here she comes, showing fight again. Body slam to the pin. One,
two, three. Astro is the new champion.
And new women's champion of the world. Astro.
Here is your winner and new honor champion.
Excuse me? Mommy? Sorry. Mommy? Sorry. Mommy?
Amazing.
Mommy? Sorry. Excuse me? Excuse me? Mommy? Excuse me? Sorry. Mommy? Sorry. Excuse me?
From almost being pinned, a two count, nearly three, to the body slam on Tifa, and pinning her to three. Wow. I mean, what a amazing ending. If only we had Astro to get what her was going through.
Hold on. She's coming in back from the ring. She's coming down. Astro.
What's up, Don? What's up, boys?
All right, Astro, congratulations on your championship belt as the new top female Spartan. How are you feeling tonight?
I feel good, honestly. It was deserved. I knew I should have got it. I am a pillar in this women's division. I have worked hard. I won the Money in the Bank. This was mine. This has been mine. I'm not going to let anyone take this from me.
Now,
that is some confidence.
With this win, Astro, you do realize that you are now a two-time world champion. How does that feel?
I am, and I am the first two-time champion in this wrestling business. I feel great. You know, I mean...
It just seems like it's second nature to you. I mean, it just comes easy.
This doesn't even feel like competition. I knew I was going to have this in the bag.
All right, well,
pure confidence.
Pure confidence.
No one
from
is
Astro.
As good as me.
And I'm now... lucky I am now a girl, because I would be afraid to fight her.
All right, well, congratulations to Astro for your
Absolutely.
Championship belt.
Hats off to her.